Speaking of music, I've got Shelly on the phone. Hi, Shelly Hendrix.
Hi. Hi, Cindy. How are you doing?
I am doing great, and I'm so glad you called in. We're really, really, really thrilled to talk about what's going to be coming up, which is Sing It Maui. Sing It Maui is started last year, and I was blessed to be able to be there and to be a judge. And I was blown away by the talented young people. And it's coming for its second year. It's for young people ages 10 to 18. And, boy, you came up with an amazing prize. $1,000 for first place, $500 for second, and $300 for third. But the reason I'm really happy you called in today, Shelly, I know you're super busy.
That's okay. This is worth it.
It is.
Yeah.
You, in fact, this is a dream of yours, actually. You had a dream to try to help young people be heard, right?
Oh, most definitely. I think when I was young, I loved to sing. And if anyone has ever experienced, I don't know, someone telling them they weren't very good or... You know, I just think it's something that every child, if they love to do it, that they should be given that opportunity. So I just love this. And last year it was so exciting to have so many. I mean, all the kids were so awesome. I'm glad I wasn't judging.
It was so hard.
Yeah.
We didn't get angry, but I mean, it's like there was lots of debates. Because it was almost actually impossible because there were so many great ones. And
yeah.
It was interesting because we did get to see the ones that you could see that the power of MAPPA and other people who have young people who'd had training maybe at Seabury Hall and others. When they have that training, it does make a difference. And thank gosh, we've got some wonderful young people that have been able to get help with their talent.
But, you know, there's so much talent on Maui. And it's just amazing to see them all come out to this competition, and then you really see it.
Absolutely.
Even to be a spectator and to watch, it's exciting. So
it was, you know what? It was a great afternoon of entertainment. Now, the event doesn't happen till Saturday, June 23rd at the Lahaina Cannery Mall, and that's going to be 3 o'clock to 5, thank you, because it's not so hot there then. So that's nice in the afternoon there.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the thing. I mean, we've been talking about it some, but even though the event's not until June 23rd, it's important for these young people to get their video audition, 3-minute video audition in right away. Because the initial deadline, which might be extended, is the initial deadline is this Saturday, June 9th, correct?
Yes, yes.
And tell me what you're looking for and what should people submit?
Most times, you know, we get people submitting videos. They upload them on YouTube and then send a YouTube link or just MP4s.
Mm-hmm.
It's tough to do sometimes with the size of the file being large. So a lot of times I'm finding they're putting them on YouTube for the most part.
Well, that's a good way to go anyway, because it's good to know how to navigate that and get that up there, because they're going to get seen by a lot of other people too, right?
Right, yeah. And so definitely...
It could be just done with their friend or their mom or relative could hold an iPhone and just record them, right?
Oh, yes, absolutely. Yes, and we had some people submit or have had some performance videos, but they can just be done like practice videos as well.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm. And the thing is, you also would like with that, and you're keeping it simple, why you love to sing, right?
Yes, that's we just ask that they add contact information and the age, and tell us why you love to sing. So pretty simple. And email the videos to singitmaui@gmail.com.
singitmaui@gmail.com. Now, the one thing that we have found, and we found this last year too, right, that you found that people waited. And I understand this. I really do, you know. I mean, it's procrastination is really... I think there was a thing that says it's a sign of genius, but there's a tendency for people to want to wait and do it right and try to get it perfect. And And the idea on this is you don't want to wait because you're going to be picking the actual contestants in advance. So
yes,
by waiting, you're going to be actually losing out. If you wait too long, you're just not going to get a chance to even get a chance to get in. And if you don't try, you are not going to get in.
Unfortunately, that happens. We get so many videos. So the sooner you can get them in, the better. And then we choose 10 finalists for the competition. And it's tough to choose.
Well,
that's for sure.
It is. I know it really is. And there were more last year, but the problem is when you have too many, you know, if there's a glitch and someone has their problem with their own sound that they bring or something, and if it goes later long, then everything gets backed up. And that can happen in something like this, you know.
Right, and that's why we cut it down. It's such an intense competition that I think people can only handle 2 hours.
Yeah.
It's very intense, you know. Everyone's on the edge of their seats waiting and waiting to see who's going to win. So it's pretty exciting.
Well, it was very exciting last year. I'm trying to think back, and there was a young, talented young singer. I think he was only like 12, wasn't he? Was he 12 or 13 last year? And he was very, very talented, you know. And it was just, but there were so many others that were talented. And it's like, the one thing is that you get really kind of afraid of rejecting them or saying no to them, because some of these young people could go on to be so great, you know.
That's the downside of it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's true. And but, you wish you could just take them all into the competition.
But you came up with some really amazingly generous prizes. I mean, typically you don't get $1,000 first prize. Was that Lahaina Cannery Mall, or how did you come up with this?
Yeah, Lahaina Cannery Mall sponsoring the competition and donating the prize money, giving the prize
well,
money.
Well, I applaud Lahaina Cannery Mall.
Yeah.
I mean, that's very generous. You know, that really is extremely generous. And I know they were out there last year, and you saw it. I mean, you were there, right? You were there taking the names at the desk. And your husband, who I just adore, Rock Hendricks, was there helping out. And here he is. He's a world-famous rock saxophone, jazz saxophone, smooth jazz saxophone player who is renowned around the world. And here he is doing the sound system there.
He's a pro at that, so I was very grateful he was there. Yeah.
You know, and you enlisted his help to get, you know, get it all going and rolling, and it, this is the kind of thing that you'd only really see like this on Maui, and it was very, it did feel very local and very Maui like that, because you know, I mean, Rock could be in L.A., and you could be in L.A. doing this, and Rock could be doing, you know, major studio work and getting paid super big bucks, you know. Instead, he's here, and you have your own little place, and you do your own little music, and he plays with the local bands. He's played with Mick Fleetwood, of course, and Eric Gilliam, and a lot of the players, you know, and they just totally respect him.
Yeah.
And respect him because he's great, and they know he's great. And yet he's out here trying to support and help people with things like this. Sing It.
Well, he likes to help kids, so this is a great opportunity.
He does.
To do that.
He absolutely does. And it takes that, you know, it takes a village, and it takes a village like Maui to be able to do that. And I think we're so blessed to have groups like Seabury Hall and MAPPA and some of the other wonderful teachers that are out there.
Mm-hmm.
To make that difference in a child's life. You saw it. Just getting up there for someone who's between 10 and 18 years old, for some of them it was their first time. And it's very nerve-wracking for the kids. They were dressed professionally. They had the makeup, they had the hair, they had the dress. You could see they'd really rehearsed and practiced, right?
They really put on a performance.
Yeah.
It was a real show. And I think some of them probably were nervous, but really they hit it so very so well.
Yeah, and I you can't help but wonder, you know, where are these young people going to be able to go with it? You know, I mean, they're lucky they can be a part of this, but this is part of their resume. This is something they can put out there. You know how important having a platform and a resume is as an artist.
That's right. Yes.
And so that's why, I mean, I know there's people listening out there that know someone who they've heard who's a very, very talented young singer. And maybe they're nervous about it and you're going, oh, gosh, I don't know. But this is their opportunity. This is an opportunity of a lifetime. I mean, with $1,000, you could get a really good vocal coach. You know, you could actually do a song. You know what was interesting last year? Remember last year how there were some really talented young people? A few had written their own original piece of music. Remember that?
Yeah, there were quite a few, actually.
Yeah, so, that wrote their own music and sang, and some of them played their own instruments. Now, how does that work? Because, I mean, I had someone actually asking me today how that worked, and I wasn't completely clear.
Oh.
How do they do the, can they bring in their guitar, can they play ukulele, or is it got to be with a sound, or how does that all work out?
If they want to play their own song, they can bring a guitar, ukulele, or just bring their iPhone, whatever. We had some people bring CDs, so whatever they want to play the music on. We just need to know in advance before the competition, and then we get it all set up. So it runs pretty smoothly.
Now, I have to ask, as someone I know that they're sisters, and they sing together. They're both fairly young, but they sing together. And how does it work? Can you take a duo or a duet? I mean, or do they have to be individual?
Well, in the rules and regulations, we have it as individuals, just to make it simplify it.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, you don't want to limit people from trying. So that's a good question.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to put you on the spot, but that was a question asked to me, and I didn't know the answer. You know, so I'm going, well, yeah, I know they always sing together, so
well,
it's
just tell them to send the video. We'll
send
it,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And it's, you know what, otherwise it's pretty open. I mean, you're not saying, you're wide open to any kind of performance music. It's not limited to one style of music, is it?
No, it's open as long as its lyrics are clean.
Mm-hmm.
You know, none of the, you know, the rap kind.
Mm-hmm. Well, rap's okay as long as it's clean. Yeah, I think
wasn't there
one rap last year? There was one young guy that did a rap that was actually very talented. Remember him?
Great, yeah, awesome rap. And there was some performances last year.
Well, I'm honored because you asked me to emcee it, and I am really glad that I can be out there to do that because I think I have the same feeling you do, and I really have always tried to support music and musicians, and it starts with that encouragement when you're young. I was blessed because I went to a school that had a good music program, and although I didn't really keep up my own singing and playing, I certainly appreciated the music enough to get into the music field and, you know, writing lyrics and music and supporting it through my work here at the radio station, other people's music and lyrics. And I think you have that same love to want to support the young people. And I know Rock does as well. Rock, I mean, I'm going to let people know I'm very excited because I'm going to be going up after I get through with the show here. And George Kamoko is, I'm putting a new CD together. CD is going to be called A Place of Peace. And I'm really excited about it. It's going to be my sixth CD. And I write words, you know, so I have some lyrics and music and words. But George is going to come, and he's going to lay down some musical tracks and I think even sing a song or two. And we're going to go up to, I haven't ever seen your studio, but Rock has a studio. And so we're going to get a chance to go up there. And I'm just so excited to be able to create music, which to me is one of the most exciting, wonderful things in the world, at Rock's studio there.
Mm-hmm.
And Rock is going to help out with a couple tracks. And that's the kind of thing that makes dreams really come true. And Rock is very involved in helping many people like that. And, I mean, where's he been playing lately? I know he was doing a couple of gigs. Where's he been playing lately?
He plays Friday nights at Longy's in Lahaina.
Oh, really?
Yeah, 7 to 9.
Nice.
And then he plays at the Lahaina Yacht Club, 6 to 9, Saturday night.
He got some nice exclusive places, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, did you get a free dinner?
Sometimes, I guess, yeah. I'm the roadie. Moving equipment.
Yeah, that's the thing, the schlepping, right? Yeah. You're the schlepper.
All part of being a musician.
Well, you know what? You're absolutely right. Absolutely right. You know, so, and I know that I've seen Rock play, and I've really been blessed to just truly just sit there with my jaw drop when I see him play, because he's the consummate professional, great player, and there's an art to that. And you know, the cool thing is that he's it's almost miraculous. He almost lost his eyesight, and then you went through all of that and the stress and the challenges and everything that comes with it, which is kind of, I can't even imagine.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was this miraculous operation last year. You didn't even know. I think there was not, what were the odds of that happening? What were the odds of that operation?
Well, you know, he was totally blind, and the doctors, they said having the operation was the last hope, and they thought it was a long shot, but they tried it anyways. And it was such, they said it was a miracle, because he came out, I think, 2025.
Wow.
And he was 200, I don't know how the numbers go, but it was like 226 or something.
Uh-huh. Over. Yeah.
Yeah. And just off the charts. So
wow.
He sees better than I do.
isn't that absolutely amazing?
Yeah. So,
I mean, that was just like another whole lease on life to be able to do that, because trying to get around and perform and driving to Lahaina and going out there and doing that, you know, it's a lot of stress if you can't see. It's not easy.
Yeah, he struggled for his whole life.
Yeah.
So it's been pretty amazing to watch. I can't imagine what he's experienced.
Well, he plays with Paul Hardcastle. If anyone knows smooth jazz, Paul Hardcastle is one of the very top names in smooth jazz. And he's been playing with him for years. And when Paul and him put CDs out together, they're always in the Billboard top, you know, 10, 15. They do so well.
Yeah, they have another one coming out this fall. So it'll be really good.
Yeah, it's just thrilling. So this is where the music comes in and support too, you know, and Rock is going to be there. We were just talking earlier days. It's like, is he going to be a judge, or is he going to do the sound system, or can he do both? You know, but I know you're going to. And I think Jack Gist is going to be a judge. I think I asked him. I think we got that. So, but you know what? We all love music, and the thing is, it's getting harder and harder and harder for musicians to survive. I don't know how many people are aware of it, but most musicians are not making hardly any money from their CDs anymore.
No, everything's on streaming and free.
Yeah, and so you know, yeah. it's a challenge when people think, well, I want to be a musician, but how am I going to make a living, you know?
Yeah, that's the reality of it.
That's the reality of it. And so, you know, here, you know, if people are talented and singers, you know, there are ways you can do it, you know. I mean, I know some excellent singers that are out there singing on the beaches for weddings, you know.
Oh,
I mean,
yeah.
I know some really good musicians that are out there just, you know, doing it, and the people coming don't realize that this musician is like a classical, I mean, really great, great singer, you know. So, you know, but you do it because you love it, and there are amazing stories of people who do survive, who people do go on to Broadway. I know Dennis and Mona Jones have a daughter, and that their daughter went on to New York, and she got a Tony.
Wow.
I think she got two Tonys last year. She's in the top Broadway show right now in New York, you know.
That's amazing.
So it does happen, and you know what? It's needed. The musicians need to give hope to the next generation, so they don't go, well, what's the point? I can't make a living on this. I can't do this. Why am I going to even try, right?
It's interesting because people have asked Rock, you know, why did you become a musician? And his answer was, I didn't have a choice.
Mm.
Because he was drawn to do that as a child and loved the sax and just became really good at it. But that's an interesting answer.
Well, that's the only answer, really. Yeah, I mean, if you have to do it, you have to do it. And we know many wonderful musicians here that have to wear a few hats just to be able to say they can do that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Or if they're working, they get probably a 1/100th of what they probably really worth.
I think that's true. Yeah.
Just to
be. Unfortunately.
Yeah. This kind of music and singing it, when you see these young people out there, I want to encourage everyone to mark their calendar to come out on Saturday, June 23rd. Because you know what? It just makes your heart feel good. When you see these talented young people singing, you just are blown away by the talent of these people. And it gives you hope. And you see how hard they've worked and you see what they've got to offer. And your applause and your support of them makes a huge difference as well.
The energy is electrifying in the competition.
Yeah.
And there's just so much talent and they all love it so much. So it's really amazing to see.
It is. It really is. So it's Sing It at Lahaina Cannery Mall, Saturday, June 23rd, 3 till 5. And but young 10 to 18, you got to get your video 3-minute recording in. It could be MP4, MP3. But you got to get it in by Saturday, June 9th, till midnight. Now, that might be extended, but we're saying that knowing you're going to wait till the last minute. And also include in your email contact name, phone number, as well as a short bio, and tell us why you'd love to sing. And then all the clips will be reviewed, and the judges will select 10 lucky contestants to perform as finalists at the Sing It competition. And the contestants will be notified if they are one of the lucky contestants chosen on June 15th. Now, so get that in, do it, and you know what? You got a really good shot. It's not like trying to go and audition for American Idol, okay? No one's going to give you a hard time. You don't have millions of people trying, you know? And so you really have a good opportunity to get either the $1,000 first place, $500 second, or $300 third. And I just have to say, I know how hard you work, Shelley, in putting this all together. And it wouldn't happen without you.
It's a labor of love.
It
absolutely.
Yeah, no, it absolutely is. And we're just very, very, very happy to be a sponsor. And want to thank you so much for giving all these wonderful young people an opportunity like this. So you get an opportunity, folks. Take it. Don't miss it. An opportunity is knocking. Knock, knock, knock.
I look forward to receiving the videos. Can't wait.
Yes, absolutely. Well, thank you. I know you got a very busy schedule, Shelley, but I appreciate you taking the time to call in. It's really wonderful to talk to you.
Well, it's great to talk to you, and thank you for your time.
Thank you. Aloha.
Aloha.